Amen. Good morning and welcome to Cornerstone. My name is Greg. I serve as the lead pastor here. And as you can see, things look a little different up front today. We have some special guests in worship today with us. We just want to introduce, this is Thomas. He serves as the worship pastor at Turlock Covenant Church. Can we say welcome? We're going to welcome him this morning. And if you don't know, the reason Thomas sounds just a little funny is that he's from Sweden. And he brought some of his Swedish family here this morning, and we're going to meet them in just a few moments. But this morning, as we think about who is the church, you know, the church is the full people of God. From his children to our seniors, we are all one in the Lord Jesus Christ. And so this Sunday, though, we thought we would do worship slightly different. And we are going to bring our children in here, and our worship service is going to be, we're going to be singing children's songs this Sunday. Yeah. And it's going to be so much fun. And listen, I want you this morning to find your inner child. And I want you to dance a little bit. I want you to clap a little bit.
All right. Let's see if we could find some joy in this room. I don't know, kids, if you've heard this song ever before. I've got the joy. Have you heard that song before? Maybe not like that. Yeah, maybe you can sing it better than I can. I think so. Hey, this girl right here, her name is Hannah. Say hi, Hannah.
Hi, everybody.
And that guy over there in the rock and roll hairstyle, his name is Leonard. Can you say Leonard? Hi, Leonard.
Hi, Leonard.
They are from a group in Sweden that are holding like huge children concerts and stuff and playing rock and roll for kids. So they will teach you a couple of songs today as well. And we'll sing some that I think you know real well. So how about this?
I've got the joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart. Joy down in my heart, down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart. I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. I've got the peace that passes understanding down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart. I got the peace that passes understanding down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to stay. I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart.
Yes. Oh, I got joy. Where? In my heart, right? Let's see if you know this one. King of the Jungle, yeah. So who's the king of the jungle? Jesus, yeah. And who's the king of the sea? Jesus, okay. Well, in my text right here, it says, who's the king of the jungle? Who? Can you do that? Who's the king of the jungle?
Who?
Who's the king of the sea? Ba, 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 ba. Can you say that? That's tricky. Who's the king of the sea? Ba, 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 ba. This is like a fish or an eel or something. I don't know. Oh, ba, 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 ba. You can swim like that. All right, let's try this. And who's the
king of the young? Who's the king of the sea? Who's the king of the universe? Who's the king of me? I tell you, J-E-S-U-S. Yes, he's the king of me. He's the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea. Ba, 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 ba. Who's the king of the jungle? Who's the king of the sea?
Ba, 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 ba.
Who's the king of the universe? Who's the king of me? I tell you, J-E-S-U-S. Yes, he's the king of me. He's the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea. Ba, 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 ba.
And we'll change the key.
Who's the king of the jungle? Who's the king of the sea? Who's the king of the universe? Who's the king of me? I tell you, J-E-S-U-S. Yes, he's the king of me. He's the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea. He's the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea. And he's the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea.
Something like that.
Yay.
How about that, huh?
Uh-huh.
Hoo, hoo. Ba, 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 ba. All right. Ba, 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 ba. I mean, Leonard.
What's next? Next song is called The Tiger, and it's about that we're different. Just look around. Is it anyone here who's very good at running fast? Raise your hand. Okay, you're fast, and you're fast. Is it anyone here who's very good at a different name on flowers? No one?
Maybe.
Maybe someone adult? But you are. Very
yeah, maybe.
Good. You are? Good. Is it anyone here who is good at sleeping long, long in the morning? You are. Yeah. We are different because God made us that. And this song, you can look at Hannah.
Yeah, I have some moves that you can do. Like, sneak like a tiger is like this.
Yeah.
And spying like an owl.
Owl, spy like an owl.
Yeah, and what's the next thing?
What about jump just like a kangaroo?
Can you do this,
yes,
everybody? Kangaroos jump like this.
Yeah, yeah, all of them.
Yeah, and then we try to sneak like a tiger. Good. And spying like an owl.
What about run just like a horse?
How does
well,
it
work? Can you?
No, think, well, yeah, it's a different good. Lyric Look, in Swedish. Yeah. Yeah, we run like
what
a horse.
What about swim like a fish? All
yeah,
fish, they swim
they
like
swim
this.
They swim like this,
have
these
you seen
fishes.
It? Yeah, all of them.
And the birds sing like this. Yeah.
All right, tell me, we start the song and you can look at Hannah and do the same moves.
Yeah.
Jump just like a kangaroo. Sneak just like a tiger. Spy just like an owl. We are all different. God made us different. Run us like a horse. Swim like just a fish. Sing just like a bunny. We are all different. God made us different. God made us different. We know different things. Cause we're all a part of God's big family. Work just like a wild boar. Slack just like a cat. Count with me to four. Can't you let me? One, two, three, four. God makes us all different. We know different things. It doesn't really matter, cause we're all a part of God's big family. God makes us all different. We know different things. It doesn't really matter, cause we're all a part of God's big family.
You're very good. Next song is a little bit more rock and roll. It's called the Party. Yeah, and you know, kids, when you have gone to bed at night, Mom and Dad, I think, they stand in front of the mirror and sing, rock and roll, rock and roll. It could be like that, because this song is like this. We will play some rock and roll. Rock and roll, rock and roll. Can you do that? We will play some rock and roll.
Rock and roll, rock and roll.
Mom and Dad could too. That's good. Yeah, Thomas, you can start it. We will play some rock and roll.
Rock and roll, rock and roll.
We will dance and have fun. We will all be big, big, big family. Everyone can join.
Come and join, come and join.
Either tiny or big. It doesn't matter if your age is 99, 10 or 2. Cause Jesus is our King, come on and enter Johnny. Na 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 na. Yeah, we're at the party, we're at the feast. Cause Jesus is our King, come on and enter Johnny. Na 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 na. The way that you are, it is the best that you can be yourself. One is pretty small,
pretty small, pretty small.
Another very tall. Another got a constant working at the mall. We're at the feast, cause Jesus is our King, come on and enter Johnny. Na 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 na. Yeah, we're at the party, we're at the feast, cause Jesus is our King, come on and enter Johnny. Na 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 na. King, come on and empty Johnny. Na 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 na. Yeah, 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 yeah. We're at the party, we're at the feast. Jesus is our King, come on and empty Johnny.
As you can tell, we have some special guests with us this morning, and I would really love for us to get to know some of our guests. Does that sound fun to you?
Yes.
And so what we're going to do is have a little interview session, and so come on up, folks. You guys can grab, want to come into, step into the light, and there's a microphone, Thomas, we're not giving you a microphone. We don't want you to talk.
You're just cute.
You're just cute. That's a sister, by the way. Let me give you some connections, right? So how do we do this? This is Thomas, and he serves as the worship pastor at Turlock Covenant Church, and we're so glad to have you this morning. I told Thomas, and he didn't do it. I said, Thomas, I need you to make some really big mistakes when you lead worship so people appreciate it when I lead more. He didn't do that. He did a really great job. It was awesome. And this is his sister, And I'm going to say it right. So they're from Sweden, and so they say their name's a little different. Her name is Hannah, but the correct way to say your name is, let's do it in your mind.
Hannah,
is that? Yeah. Hannah? I'm horrible at accents. All my accents
but
sound the same.
It's good. Hannah.
It's good? So Hannah, and this is, I think I would normally say Leonard, but the way he says it is much cooler, and so... Leonard, could you say your name the way it's meant to be said?
My name is Leonard.
Leonard.
Try to do it.
Leonard.
And you're from Sweden. You still live in Sweden. And
Yeah, we do.
You do? Or do you want to move here? Because we would love to take you.
Well, when we left Sweden, it was kind of gray and cold. So this is like a Swedish summer for us.
Yeah.
This is like Swedish summer. I love it. Okay, very cool. Now, what I want to do, I'm just going to ask you guys some questions to get to know you a little bit. And I want us to hear what God's doing through you so that we can just celebrate God's work around the world and in Sweden, but also for us to be encouraged in our work, that we would go forth and do what you guys are doing in the name of Jesus together. So my first question is, do you speak Swedish?
Yes.
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 Ja, det gör vi. Vi pratar mycket svenska.
Yeah, I agree.
Ja, eller hur?
Now, you need to know we have a lot of different folks here, as you can see, but we do have some who've come from the Swedish background. And can you raise your hand if you are Swedish? See, we got a couple.
Yeah.
They're okay.
Do they speak Swedish?
Well, that's what I'm gonna say. Keep your hand raised if you speak Swedish. Anybody?
Are you doing?
Any?
Oh,
hey, hey.
Lorraine does.
Hey.
So you see that hand over there? That's Lorraine Bostrom. She's so sweet. Now, could you speak an encouraging word to Lorraine in Swedish? Could you say something to her in Swedish that only she will know, that she will just appreciate?
Du är älskad av Jesus.
Oh, try again. Talk louder.
Jesus. Älskar dig.
Now it's, tell you what.
Yeah.
Let me interpret. I heard the word Jesus in there.
Yeah, Jesus.
That's good. Jesus is Lord?
Jesus loves you.
Jesus loves you.
Yeah.
I heard it out there. So cool.
Couldn't be better.
Well, thank you. Well, okay, so before we talk about why you're here in the States, I was so encouraged earlier when you were sharing with me about your ministry in Sweden, because your ministry is expanding the kingdom of God. So their ministry is called Youngsters in Sweden. They are not a church, but they work alongside of the church. And they're reaching people, and I want to hear you to hear how they're reaching people. So if you could just share about your ministry and what you do with God.
Okay, so the little background of Youngsters is that we belong to a movement called the Oasis Movement. And we have our roots in the Swedish church, but we are working with different churches, like the Pentecostal and, Orthodox and everybody. And Youngsters is the part of Oasis that works with the kids and the children. And our main thing that we want, our vision and mission is that we want to tell the kids in Sweden about Jesus. So that's a pretty good thing. And
That's pretty good.
Thing.
That's not too bad. That's
That's
why we're all here, right?
Yeah, we think it's really important that kids have their own faith early, so they are not having their parents' faith or things like that. They have their own experience and meeting with God. Yeah.
Amen.
So our main thing that we do, that you started in 1999, like 17 years ago.
Yeah, I started in 1999 because I love kids, I love Jesus, and I love rock and roll. And we started a rock and roll band who played rock and roll songs about Jesus for kids.
Yeah.
And that's the start.
Cool.
So we are traveling around in Sweden with our bus and our truck. And we put up rock and roll concerts for the kids. And we think that it's important that you not only are in the church, that you meet the kids that are outside the church also. Because the kids in the church, they have their belief, and that's important. And it's important to encourage them too. But we want the kids outside the church to know that it's one person that loves them really, really much for who they are. as they are.
Okay, cool.
So I can tell when we were at Kisa. Yeah? There was a place in Sweden called Kisa. How do you say? Samhälle? Community, yeah? So it's a little community in Sweden. And the congregation there called us and said, hello, we want you to come over here and have a concert for the kids. We said, yeah, we are coming. And before we have the rock concert for the kids, we want to travel to Kisa then, maybe 10 days before the rock concert. Yeah, just you and me, because we want to visit the children in their school. So we go around to the different classrooms, and we tell them about the golden rule, how to be a good friend, because in the school in Sweden, you are not allowed to talk about Jesus. Almost in the Swedish church, you are not allowed to talk about Jesus anymore. It's going down. So we are not allowed to talk about Jesus, but we talk about the golden rule and how to be a good friend. And if a kid asks, like, who said that rule? Then we can say, oh, it's Jesus.
Smart.
Yeah, that's really smart. And then we play a song, and then we invite them to a free rock concert. And when we say that, the kids are like, yeah, we want to go. So in Kisa, when we have the rock concerts, they came 300 kids, and 90% of them were not kids that went to the church, usually. And there were different religions, too. So it was like a hard time to have that concert, but very, very important. And we also want the concert not to be in the church, because in Sweden, I don't know how it is here, but in Sweden, the people are a little afraid to be in the church. Like, they're not knowing what's happened there. So we had the concert usually at the kids' school, because that's their home. And we had the concert, and a few months later, we got a text message from the congregation. And they said to us that when we had the concert, their groups for the kids in the church had grown four times bigger. Do you say four times bigger? Yeah, and families start to accept Jesus and take Jesus in their lives. And it's really encouraging for us to know that too, because when you are out and traveling, you don't see the results immediately. Mm-hmm. So that's really important and fun.
Wow, yeah. That is awesome.
So that's our main thing.
Great. When can you start that in Turlock? What an encouragement to hear you guys share a little bit. How about just one more simple question? You've done a wonderful job sharing with us about your ministry. As we pray for you, how can we be praying for you while you're here and as you go back?
Well, how you could pray for us before we go back or when we go back?
Both.
Okay.
Sorry, I ask very broad questions. They're more fun that way.
Well, I think that God is blessing our work. I think that's the important thing.
The most important for us is to go the way Jesus wants us to go, not our own way.
Yeah.
We want to follow him in every step. And it's sometimes quite hard because you need money and you need other stuff. But we know if you follow Jesus, he will always give us.
He will always provide, right?
Yeah.
If you're in his will, he will always provide for your needs. I love that.
Faith to do that.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Okay, we can pray. And I realized, you know, the problem with not having my questions written down here, I missed an important question because obviously you do ministry in Sweden and you're here in Turlock. And so for what purpose has God brought you to the Central Valley? Why are you here in the United States for these couple weeks?
Well, Thomas called us.
Yeah. Maybe I should answer. Yeah. And the reason, the cause for bringing them over here. So Hannah already explained that the environment in Sweden, the Christian environment, is getting tougher in the Swedish Lutheran Church. You don't really talk about Jesus. You talk about a light, you know, but you don't really mention the name of Jesus. And same things in the school, and it's just and then you have the side where you know the kids' attention span is short and they're out, you know, on their phones or they're, you know, playing computer games or whatever. You know, so how do you, and I see that here as well. You know? And I saw a pattern. And even though this country, you could still, you know, say God bless America. You know, and that's great. But we don't say that in Sweden.
Not at all.
Because that would be offending to people that are not Christians. And so before, and I could see maybe this country going down the same route if you're not careful, you know. And so I wanted to bring over these people with their ideas and what they've seen in the past 17 years working in this environment. Like, how do we reach kids in this, you know, day and age with the gospel in a way that is relevant?
We always have to find new ways to reach the kids about the gospel because it's changing so fast back in Sweden. Really changing fast. Like, this thing that you not allowed, or maybe you don't speak so much about Jesus in the church, it just changed for like the few years.
That's right. And you have, how many are on your team that are involved with hauling of the instruments and light rigs and
so we have a team of volunteers of maybe 15 to 20 people that think very this cool. is very important. So it's great for us to have them.
And you have this big tour bus and this big old truck with equipment, and so obviously it's just a fraction of what they are and what they do, but we're so happy to have them here, and it's not to impose something on anyone, but just to encourage and to give all of you and the places that we're going some ideas or some heads up or some, you know, encouragement that this is what we've been doing. Maybe it will work here as well.
And also, I just have to say, when you work with the kids and their faith, you're not the reason that they have their faith. You make a possibility for them to meet God. That's the thing. But when you are close to the kids, when they have their meeting with God, when they have, like, in the, what do you say, förbön, personal prayer moment, yeah? The kids' faith is so real. You know, we grown-ups, we can't understand anything, and that's a problem for us, so we don't accept everything. But the kids, they just accept, and they believe in Jesus, and they believe in God, and they believe that you actually can meet God, and that's not a problem.
Yeah, we noticed one thing 17 years ago. You know, when we have meetings in Sweden, we used to put the children in the basement with some bad copy papers and broken crayons, and they could just draw some loose paintings because they don't know anything about God. But God told us one day, I want you to do the same thing with the kids as you do with the adults. Preach the gospel.
Worship
together and
pray in different ways together with them.
And it was, the kids have longing to meet Lord in that way.
Yeah.
We have seen it time after time.
Yeah, that's a really important thing. They are longing to have their personal meeting with God.
The children are really Christian.
Yeah.
And I love that because, you know what, is God has created all of us, right? Mm-hmm. He's created every human being. Our soul has been created for him. And so no soul is at peace until they know the Lord Jesus Christ to whom we've been created for. And I also think as I hear you talk, you know, the good news of Jesus, the gospel that Christ, he went to the cross to pay for our sins so that we could be forgiven and free. That is the message that message never changes, right? That will stand the test of time. But our world's changed. Sweden is changing. Our country is changing. Our community is changing. And as you folks have done, God is calling even us as a church to always be asking the question, what can we do? How can we be creative? How can we team up with God in our community? And so we're just thankful for your example and your encouragement because that's what we're trying to do here as a community. Let me throw out three advertisements. Number one, if you're just very interested you're drawn to these folks, this Thursday, on the 23rd, is it the 23rd on Thursday? Yes?
Yep.
Wonderful. At 6 o'clock, we're going to have a children's ministry training workshop at Turlock Covenant Church, and they're going to be leading this together. And so if you just want to go, they're so cool, let's hang out more, you can go there at 6, or if you just want to learn more about how to minister to kids, you're welcome to be there at 6 o'clock. There is a sign-up on a sheet. There's a table. As you leave the sanctuary, you can sign up just so we know who's going to go and we can be prepared for the people we have. The second thing, if you're a parent and you said, you know what, I want my kids to experience this again and to hear more worship and good news of Jesus in a language they understand, this Friday at what time, Thomas? Also 6 p.m. at Turlock Covenant Church, they're going to do a, they call it a rock and roll worship concert for kids. All right, and so if you have kids
God
and you want to show up. What's that?
God is rock and roll.
God is rock and roll. You know, some people in the church thought, you know, rock and roll is an interesting thing, right? Because often, it's like every genre of music. It can be good or it can be bad. And sometimes rock and roll gets a bad name because of some of the things that are associated with it. But you have redeemed that type of music for the glory of God. And that's awesome. I love that. Very good. So that's Friday. And then last but not least, where am I? Raise your hand if you're an usher. I want to make sure ushers hear this message. Dave and at least Doug, are you in here still? Doug left. Ooh, it's not good to be called out in a church. Okay, Dave and another usher, I don't care who it is, make sure at the end of the service, if you could grab a basket, stand by the door, and if you just feel compelled to minister to them financially, to help them with their cost, to come to the States and to go back, but also to further their ministry in Sweden, you're welcome to give a love offering on the way out. Look for the basket. We'll hopefully have an usher or two holding, and you can donate to their cause and bless them from our church. That sound good to you guys?
The most important thing is not the money for us. It's the blessing, we think.
Amen.
Yeah.
Good. Then we're going to take an offering for me, and we're going to bless the... I'm so joking. That's a horrible joke. Pastors should not make jokes like that. Hey, what's that? Yeah, if you want to write a check, you can write a check to?
To Turlock Covenant Church.
Write it out to Turlock Covenant
Church.
Actually,
let's do this. Write a check to Cornerstone Covenant Church, and then we'll write a check to you guys. That's probably the best way for us to do that. So just write a check to Cornerstone. Just make sure you write in the memo, write youngsters. Or you forget youngsters, write kids from Sweden. Or... really cool people back, who led worship today, whatever.
Back in Sweden, when we say our name to like the more adults in the church, they think that we are saying gangsters.
Gangsters.
So here's gangsters. No.
We're glad you're not gangsters. God bless you. All right. Hey, can we pray for you? And then we're going to keep moving on in worship. Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for divine appointments in God, that we are reminded this morning that your church goes way beyond this little place we call Cornerstone Covenant Church. And God, it's so good to see that your spirit is moving across the globe, even in places where the church is dying. In so many ways, God, you are always working and bringing new life. And so we pray, Spirit, that you would continue to bring revival in Turlock, in our country, in Sweden, and all across the world. We thank you for the youngsters ministry, for Leonard, for Hannah, God. We pray in Jesus' name that you would continue to provide for all of their needs. God, we pray that you would open up pathways, that you would give divine opportunities so that they may minister the gospel of grace to children in Sweden. May their time here in the States be encouraging, may it be fun, and Lord, bring them back safely to the calling that you've put on them. Lord, we thank you that you are God and that we are not, and we pray in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you so much for being a part of our worship today. It truly was so much fun. I loved it. More people than average were dancing this morning. That's very cool. And you should also, yeah, there you go.